Hi everyone, welcome to this video on getting started with a Angular tree grid of SyncFusion. Tree grid is a feature-rich component used to visualize self-referential hierarchical data effectively in a tabular format. In this video, I will set up the Angular environment by creating an Angular CLI project, and I will show you how to create an Angular tree grid with the required columns. I will also show you how to define the parent-child relationship among the data using the expand and collapse options. After creating tree grid, I will add the prominent features to it like paging, sorting, and filtering. Now, let me proceed to create an Angular CLI project first. For that, one should have a basic understanding of NPM, Angular, HTML, and JavaScript. I will use the Visual Studio Code Editor to work with the tree grid code example and Chrome browser to view the output. Open the Visual Studio Code to create an Angular CLI project. Select the workspace folder and open the terminal. Type in the command npm install -g at Angular CLI to install Angular CLI in your machine globally. Create a new Angular project using the command ng new getting started, where getting started is the project name. Choose whether to enable Angular routing in your application and select the style sheet format. This will create a new Angular project along with its dependencies. Now let me navigate to the project folder by typing cd getting started. Now I will move on to the second part of the video, adding the Angular tree grid to the Angular CLI project. Use the command ng add SyncFusion EJ Angular tree grid to install the Angular tree grid packages along with its dependencies. This will also import the necessary modules and CSS references of TreeGrid as well. Use the Explorer and navigate to the SRC and App folder. Open the App module TS file and you can see the imported TreeGrid modules here. Import TreeGrid module from SyncFusion EJ Angular TreeGrid. You can also see the TreeGrid module in the Imports array of ng module section. The CSS file reference of TreeGrid can be seen in the style.css file. Now open the file src app appcomponent.html. I can directly add the EJS TreeGrid tag selector to add a simple Angular TreeGrid component. As the TreeGrid will not be visible with no data on it, I will add data to this TreeGrid now. For that, I am adding a new file named datasource.ts. Defined with an array of JavaScript data objects in it with relevant fields. To assign this data to the tree grid, open the appcomponent.ts file and import the data from the datasource.ts file. In the appcomponent class, create an object of array type. In the ng onInit method, assign the sample data value to the data object. In the HTML template, specify the data source of the tree grid with the created data object. Now I have set the data source for Angular tree grid. So I will run the application using the command ng serve -- open in the terminal. You can see the tree grid with all its columns present in the data source. The tree grid looks like a flat grid component. So I will add few child records to it and enable the expand and collapse button on specific column to make its appearance look like a tree grid. Say for example, I will add the expand and collapse option on the second column of tree grid. To add the child records, first I will assign the subtask field to the actual data source, which holds the collection of child tasks that are assigned to each individual parent task. Open the appcomponent.html file and define the child mapping property on tree grid with the subtask field name from the data source to convey the tree grid. Whichever records should act as child rows. Now to display the expand and collapse button on the second column of the tree grid, let me add the tree column index property to tree grid and set its value as 1, which represents the index value of the second column. After setting these properties, you can see the tree grid now with the child records added to specific rows on the tree grid, as well as the expand and collapse button displaying on the second column based on its index value. If you would like to show only specific columns and customize them on the tree grid, then you may need to define the needed columns as an array in the HTML template using the columns directive. The field property refers to the data source field name in the array of JavaScript objects. The header text holds the display text for that column in the tree grid. The text align property aligns the text in the column. By default, columns will be aligned to the left. To change that, say for example on the numeric column types, assign the value right instead. The width property sets the width for that column. Also, you can format the display of number and date values on the tree grid columns using the format property. Save your changes and you can see the tree grid with the formatted columns. Let me move on to the third and final part of this video, adding important features to the Angular tree grid. The tree grid component has a powerful set of features like paging, sorting, filtering, exporting, and many more. They are segregated as modules, and to use any specific features, you can import that specific module from the package. Let me add the paging, sorting, and filtering features now. To enable paging, open the app-module.ts file, import the module page-service, and add it to the providers array in the ng-module section. In the app-component.ts file, import the page-settings model. In the app-component class, create a page settings model object and name it page settings. In the ng onInit method, set the value. You can provide the page size to show the number of rows per page. Open the appcomponent.html file and add the allow paging property to tree grid and set its value as true. Also, assign the page related options to the page settings property. Now save the file and you can see the tree grid updated with a pager. To enable sorting, open the appmodule.ts file and import the module sort service. Add it to the providers array in the ng module section. In the appcomponent.ts file, import the sort settings model. In the appcomponent class, create a sort settings model object and name it sort settings. In the ng onInit method, set the value for sort settings. You can provide the columns in an array to be sorted. Here, the task name column is set to sort in ascending order and task ID column is set to sort in the descending order. Open the appcomponent.html file and add the allow sorting property to the tree grid and set its value to true. Also, assign the sort related options to the sort settings property. Now save the file. You can see the tree grid with the task name and task ID columns sorted with the provider direction and their orders updated in the numbers as 1 and 2 respectively. To enable filtering, open the appmodule.ts file and import the module filter service. Add it to the providers array in the ng module section. Open the appcomponent.html file and add the property allow filtering and assign the value as true. Now save the file. You can see the tree grid with the default filter bar enabled. Type in any expression on the filter UI to filter and display the matching records of both the parent and child on the tree grid. There are other customization options available in filtering which I will cover in the upcoming videos. Finally, let me summarize some of the main points. I have explained the steps to create an Angular CLI project and add an Angular tree grid component to it along with the important features paging, sorting, and filtering. In upcoming videos, you will learn how to bind data, edit, filter, sort, export, and select tree grid data and templates to a tree grid and customize its columns with various options. If you find this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching this video.